I first met Michelle Allswager and her son Jesse 3 years ago when the two were guests on this very set to talk about juvenile diabetes and a then new monitoring device for kids. Sadly, Jesse passed away due to complications of the disease earlier this year at the young age of 13. Back with me tonight is Michelle Allswager, Jesse's mom, to talk about an upcoming event in her son's honor to raise money for the cause. It's so great to see you.
Thanks for having me.
I have to ask you first, because I know everyone is wondering, how are you doing?
Well, you know, we're moving forward is what every family has to do, and trying to find ways to remember him that make people smile.
We have some video, and I know you saw it during the tease, back from that interview in 2007. We're going to show it here.
I'm not, yeah.
And you don't have to look, because I know it's hard to look at it, but what do you see as Jesse's legacy?
Well, you know, the one thing that's come out of his death, you know, ever since he was diagnosed, it's been all about finding a cure and advocating for it. And in his death, we're going to continue doing the same because, after all, he has two older sisters and a younger brother. And the last thing I'm ever going to tell them is that they have type 1 diabetes as well. So the one beautiful thing that's really come out of it is with all those 13-year-old kids learning about community and what it means and to gather together and make a difference in their community. That's the best thing.
So important to find that positive. And I'll tell you what, I remember him so well, and he was just such a sweet, positive boy, and,
yeah.
And that's what I'll remember him. I want to talk about this event on a positive note. Okay. You're really excited about it. It's next weekend, so fill us in on what's going on.
Next Saturday is, we've deemed it Jesse Palooza, and it's from noon to 9 at the Capitol Brewery. We have four bands going on throughout the day. In fact, the first band that plays is Jose and Some Limes, which is his actual guitar instructor and his drum instructor playing. Every band has to play Don't Stop Believin' by Journey, whatever rendition that is, because that's his favorite tune. And we have, my menu is donating 100% of the proceeds for the food that day. We have bouncy houses. We have family-friendly things to do. And adult libations, of course, as well.
Of course, at Capitol Brewery. Now, all of the proceeds go to JDRF, which at one point you were executive director of.
That's correct.
So tell us what that money will be used for.
Actually, there's about 80 people right here from the Madison area riding their bikes, which I started doing in 2004 in his name. We're all going out to Death Valley, and we're going to ride in Jesse's honor and make this very personal this year. But all of it goes to the Western Wisconsin chapter, all the money raised.
And I know for people who don't understand, it's really, really needed right now, especially because I know a fundraising is extra hard.
Yeah, it is. And, it's such a personal thing for so many of us who are affected by type 1 diabetes. And I think with Jesse's death, so many more people feel personally connected to this. And so, you know, we're seizing Jesse as we always did in a smiling little face.
Oh, Michelle, thank you so much. We really appreciate your coming on.
Thanks for having me.
It's great to see you and know you're doing well. And check it out. It's coming up Saturday, July 31st. If you would like more information on Jesse Palooza, just go to our web channel, NBC15.com, and click on News Links. We'll also give you a link to JDRF in the event that you'd like more information on what they have going on there.